Thank you for partnering with us in the spreading of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ around the world. Because of your generous contributions, we have been able to keep this program on the air. Plus, we have planted more than 500 churches around the world, each one reaching their communities with acts of kindness, helping abused women, helping orphans and widows. Plus, we have got more than 50 Bible schools around the world with more than 3,500 students studying right now, learning how to go out into the world and teach and preach the Word of God, start churches, and make a huge impact for Christ. Thank you for your generosity. On the screens right now is all you need to be able to continue your support. Thank you. Welcome to Christian Family Church International right here in Johannesburg. This morning's message will encourage you greatly. It'll also educate you, help you understand how to step out in faith. Stay with us. I believe you'll be greatly blessed. The church is right next to the airport here on Atlas Road, and we want to welcome you. Go ahead. All right, so what's the procedure? We find the promise of God. God promises us in His Bible to meet that need. And so we say, Father, You promised to meet that need. And based on this promise, I believe You've heard my prayer. And so now, because I believe You've heard my prayer, I want to thank You. I'm not thanking You for the problem. I'm thanking You because I know You've taken care of it. Say this, I'm not thanking God for the problem. I'm thanking Him because I know He's taken care of it. Right? So what happens when we do that? Look at the next verse. This is the result. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. And the peace of God, which our mind cannot comprehend. Our mind can't figure it out. I'm standing in the middle, in the eye of the storm. I'm standing in the eye of the storm, all hell broken loose around me. And yet, in the middle of all this turmoil, I have peace in my heart and mind. And my reason says, it's impossible for you to be so at peace, but inside, I know my Father's got this for me. Amen. You understand? Amen. Amen. The peace of God will guard your heart, will protect your mind. Isaiah 26:3. And it says, you God will keep the man or the woman in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed, whose mind is fixed on You, because he trusts in You. All right? So how do I fix my mind on God? Say this: I fix my mind on God by finding a promise from God. Now say this: when I fix my mind on a promise from God, then I have perfect peace in the eye of the storm. My mind is fixed on the promise of God, and because I'm fixed on the promise of God, I'm trusting God. The Holy Spirit is giving my heart faith and assurance. My wonderful counselor is helping me. Because your mind is fixed on the promise of God, you have peace in the storm. Here's an example, all right? Let's take this scripture, for example, Philippians 4:19. It's one I've used several times through my life, and I believe it'll help you too. And my God shall supply all your need. Say all. According to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. I'm so glad he didn't say according to earth's economy. But my God shall supply all you need according to heaven's riches. Amen? My God will meet your need according to heaven's riches. Say this: I'm not living on earth's economy. I'm living on heaven's economy. Let's take that verse and meditate on it and start saying that. I'm living by heaven's economy. My Father's providing all that I need. Start saying that to your finances. Speak to your money. Amen. Jesus said you can talk the mountain. Did he not? And Jesus spoke the tree, did he not? Fig tree. Why can't we speak to the mountain? Why can't we speak to our money? Why can't we release the angels? Of course we can. We'll learn more about that later on. Now, even though the financial pressure may be severe, even though the pressure of life may be extreme, even though there are dozens of wars raging all over the world right now, even though every country in the world is facing serious problems, you have no anxiety. You are not worried because your heart is fixed on Philippians 4:19. My God is supplying all my need. Your heart is full of peace and assurance because your heart is fixed on Philippians 4:19. My God supplies all my need. You know in your heart your Father who loves you is taking care of you because you're reading Philippians 4:19. No matter what's going on around you, Philippians 4:19 is unchangeable. It's unchangeable. Family of God, listen very carefully here. When you meditate on the Word of God like that, it does not matter how much fear you have in your heart at the time. It doesn't matter how much fear you have in your heart at the time. When you meditate on Philippians 4:19 or any promise that God gives you, faith will come in the front door and fear will flee out the back door. When faith comes in, fear has to leave. The Bible tells us that fear is a spirit. Fear is a spirit. 2 Timothy 1:7. Fear is a spirit. Say that. Fear is a demon spirit. And when the spirit of faith, the spirit of God, brings faith to my heart, that little demon has to flee in terror. Praise God. Now listen to this. Say this with me. I cannot have faith and fear in my heart at the same time. I can either have faith or fear, but not faith and fear. And so therefore, when I meditate on faith food and the faith teacher brings faith, the Holy Spirit, to my heart, that little demon has to run in terror. Praise God. Now say this. I rise up big. in the eye of the storm, on the inside. And I declare my Father is taking care of this. And guess what? It disappears. It melts away. Hold fast to your confession. Don't change your confession. Now, your friends who know you, your friends who know what you are going through, your friends who know what you are facing, may look at you and they might be thinking, how can they possibly be so calm and so secure in their problems? Your friends may be thinking about you, how can they possibly be at such peace and rest in the middle of all their problems? But it's because you have this assurance in your heart, your loving Father has promised to meet your need by His riches and glory through Christ Jesus, and you know it's true. No matter what that need might be, no matter what that circumstance might be, they don't see you, your friends do not see you at home with your hands raised to heaven and your Bible open at the promise and you thanking God for His promise and thanking Him, Father, you've taken care of me because you promised us. It's done. They don't see you worshiping God, whether it's 1 minute, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. They don't see you worshiping God and thanking Him with your Bible open, standing around your table. They don't know where your strength comes from. They don't know of the Holy Spirit who lives in your heart, who's encouraging you to face tomorrow with boldness. They don't know how on earth you're so calm and confident. I've been asked many times, why are you so confident? Why are you so confident? And I thought about it. I didn't realize I was confident. But you know what it is, family? My life's built on the Word. Why should I be walking around all full of fear and my tail between my legs like a puppy dog when God is on my side, He's in me, and He's taking care of things? I'm not being arrogant. I'm just being grateful. I'm fulfilled and happy. I'm not confident in my own strength. I'm confident in what the Father's love will provide for me. Do you understand that? That's different. It's not like these WWE wrestlers where they come in, the lights flashing, and it's not like that. We don't work that way. I'm not talking about that kind of confidence, which is short-lived, till the next fight and they get beaten up. People may say, you are in trouble now, but your heart says back to them with quiet assurance, no, my Heavenly Father's got this for me. I have inside information. Say this, no, I'm not worried. I have inside information. I know stuff you don't know. Again, I know things you don't know. I have inside information. Inside the Word of God. Hallelujah. The Comforter is in your heart, guiding you to faith and victory. Say that the Holy Spirit is in my heart, guiding me step by step to faith and victory. You know, this is how I would think this works. You know, when our children were small and grandchildren were small, still are, some of them are tiny, and they just learned to walk at about a year of age and they take their first few steps, I used to love letting them take my finger, their whole hand, around one finger. And I just like to walk with them while they take their little steps. And they hold on for dear life, boy. They won't let go. This is about pull your finger off. But they hold on, and then they walk. And they take their step, and they smile like crazy, and they're so happy and proud that they can actually put one foot in front of the other. And then if they stumble, you catch them, and you help them. You don't scold them for messing up. You just say, come on, you can do it. You can do it. Be sure, you know, calm them down, encourage them, carry on. Take the finger again, let's go. And so it is. The Holy Spirit does that with us. He teaches us how to walk this walk of faith and trust God into His wonderful blessings for our life. That's what He does. The Comforter, the Guide. He's with you every step of the way, teaching you how to step out the boat and walk on the water. Amen? Praise His wonderful name. There are three tests. I'm going to close here with this. I said all that to say this. I said everything to say this. There are three tests. You can test to see if your heart is in faith. Now, let's just recap a moment here. We have identified what the heart of man is. We understand we have to believe with the heart, not the head. We understand even though we have doubt in the head and faith in the heart, God answers our prayer. And we understand our faith works. Here are three tests. You can test to see if you are in faith, and that brings great assurance. You can test to see if you are operating in faith or doubt. Because you might say, well, I'm believing God, but you might not be. Or you might think you might be doubting, but you might not be. So how do I know that I really am operating in faith and not in doubt? Here are the three tests. You need to write this down. This will help you through the rest of your life. I would recommend you frame this, put on a wall in your house somewhere. Don't ever lose what you're going to hear now. Because you need to know that you're in faith or not in faith, no matter what happens to you in your future. Is this important? How can I tell that I'm in faith or not? Three tests. If you pass three sweet tests, you know you're in faith. This comes from the Bible. I didn't suck it out my thumb. Comes from the Bible. You ready? Test number one. If our words are words of faith continually, then we are in faith. How do I know that? Well, because Jesus said in Matthew 12, 34, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. All right, say that. Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. All right, say it this way. Jesus said, what's in the heart will come out the mouth. So say this. I can identify where anybody is at by listening to their words. I know what is in their heart. Because Jesus said, whatever's in the heart will come out the mouth. You got it? So I know if my heart's in faith, if I'm believing in the heart, by listening to my words. If I never say anything full of doubt and unbelief, if I don't say, oh, it's never going to work for me, if I don't say, oh, you know, it's too late now, it's all over, I'm in trouble, if I don't confess all that stuff, if I say, no, my Father's taking care of this, if I hold fast to that kind of talk, then I know there's faith in my heart. When you hear things like, my Father's taking care of this, then I know there's faith in the heart. Test one. All right, test number two, which we've looked at already. In the middle of the storm, while all hell's breaking loose, we have peace in our hearts. From the Word. We meditate on the Word, and peace comes, then we know we're in faith. Now, we'll all have peace when there's no storm. Anybody can have peace then. But when you're in the storm and you have peace, then you know you're in faith. And the only place that you can have faith from when you're in the storm is from the Word. Faith comes from the Word. The Holy Spirit will teach you, encourage you, and feed your faith. All right, test number three. We are acting and behaving as though we have it. We are acting and behaving as though we have the answer to our prayer. We pray, ask God, and then we act like we've got it. When my actions display I have what I asked for, then I'm in faith. Then I'm in faith. So say this, as far as possible. Or say it this way, as far as humanly possible, I must act like I got it. You know, through the years, folks have come to me and said, so-and-so's happened, told me a problem, a serious problem. And some of those problems have been shocking. And then they'd say, Pastor Theo, what are you going to do now? And I look back at them and say, I'm just going to act like the Bible's true. I'm going to act like the Bible's true. Sometimes it's not easy, but you're just going to say it. I'm going to act like the Bible's true. And start acting like the Bible's true. Start acting like your Father's got this under control. And say it. And say it. So say this. When problems come my way, I'm going to act like the Bible's true. You see, some folks, when problems come and they're serious, they act like a chicken that's had his head cut off. I don't know, you know, when I was a kid, my grandparents had a farm. And when we were going to eat chicken, they would cut the head off. And I used to go down there as a little kid and watch them cut the head off and watch that chicken. Have you ever seen a chicken when its head cut off? How many of you have seen a chicken with a head cut off? Did you know it can run? Did you know the chicken can run without a head? No kidding, it can. It'll run like crazy. Bonk. Fall down. But that's what some believers do when problems come their way. They just start totally freaking out. Totally lose it. True? Let's not be like that anymore. Because we know the answer. Run to the Bible, find the promise, open it, read it, and declare what God is doing and act like it's true. Amen? Did you learn anything? Are you glad you came to church? Well, give the Lord a praise here this morning.
All of us have to die. The question is, where do you go when you die? Are you sure you will go to heaven? If you want to be sure, receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Say this little prayer. Dear Jesus, please forgive me for my sin. Come into my heart. I declare you are the Lord of my life, and I'll live for you with all my heart from this day forward. If you said that prayer from your heart, he accepts you as his child, and we'll see you in heaven. God bless you.
To find out more about what God is doing in our church, visit our website at www.christianfamilychurchsa.com or visit us on Facebook and Twitter.
To say like the others did. Just say thank you. And when you say thank you, Jesus, the power will flow. You'll feel the power flow through your body and make you whole. All right? Stretch your hands out towards your family. There it is. Power is flowing now. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. The power is flowing through you. Power of God is all over you. There it is. There it is. Just watch her. Watch her. There it is. Watch her. There it is. Watch your head, Pastor Gordon. Thank you. All right, tell us what God did for you, dear sister. Where's the...
This arm, I couldn't lift for about a year already. I had to move the whole body over like this to can lift up my arm. I can lift this arm, this heart. The heart is feeling like a young heart.
The heart's feeling like a young heart.
Yeah, there's not these cramps and this burning sensation anymore.
No cramps and burning sensation in your heart?
Nothing. The back, the lower back part, as I sit down here, there's no pain.
There's no pain?
No pain. And I've been suffering with this back for 5+ years already.
Isn't Jesus wonderful?
Amen.
Amen.
This is your mother? Come out here and get her. She's going to walk back without her stick.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, for fixing me up today and making me feel like I'm young again.
Oh, thank you. Come on out, Chang.
I couldn't play with my grandchildren. I couldn't do anything because I was connected to the stick all the time.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God. All the glory to you, Father God. Thank you so much.
So wonderful. So wonderful. So wonderful. Now you're going to walk back, dear sister, without your stick, okay? Go on, off you go. Carry your stick. Carry your stick for her. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord.
You are invited to visit Christian Family Church, San Antonio, where Drs. Theo and Beverly are based. Come and experience the supernatural power of God, along with outstanding praise and worship and faith-building teaching from the Word of God. The church is located on Loop 1604 North at the Bulverde exit. Look for the big sign, Christian Family Church. Our service times are Saturday night at 6 p.m., Sunday morning at 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. We look forward to seeing you there. You are invited to visit Christian Family Church, San Antonio.